quality. This is two of the best times we have performed it, actually, and that's always a good thing. I also wanted to point out that this year there was no middle school honor band at Austin Peay, so we did not send any kids to honor band there. I wish there were, because they are going to try to resume that in the next year or two. But we had some outstanding eighth graders that we would have loved to have sent. We did send kids to the MTSU Honor Band, and I wanted, if you went to the MTSU Honor Band, please stand up. That would be Kenna, Phillip, let's see, who else went to the MTSU? Eric, stand up. Sky, and am I missing somebody? Okay, so this was our the kids who were selected to be part of the regional MTSU Honor Band. Let's give them a round of applause. All right, well, have a seat. And then I want to recognize the kids that went to the Austin Peay Regional Honor Band. They do it a little bit different. They have a 9th through 10th grade band and an 11th through 12th grade band. We had a great showing there. First chair tuba, 11th and 12th grade band. Noah Cartwright, you may remember him. First chair tenor sax, senior Callie Webster. Second chair out of 16 trumpets, Miss Caroline Guffey. In the 9th and 10th grade band, out of 13 trumpets, McKenna was third chair, Phillip was fourth chair, and also in the clarinet section, Miss Lydia Zarchansky. They did a great job, and I have to say, Miss Lydia is going to be attending Austin Peay in the fall and marching in their band program and hopefully playing in their wind ensemble, we hope. So, but she's scholarship on that. So, y'all have a seat. Let's give them another round. I've got to mention one thing about I also wanted to mention that Callie is probably, and I've said this to others, the most underserved kid we may have ever had. She is uber talented, and she's a team player. We have a developing jazz band, but 2 years ago when we were able to field one because we were able to meet during the class time, she's the young lady, if you remember, that sang Blue Moon. Several school board members still ask me about Callie. She's going to Belmont University in the fall, and I've talked to their director of their wind ensemble. I'm hoping that we can scholarship her there. She's got a lot of scholarship money offered to her from many other universities, but her dream is to go to Belmont. And I believe we're going to be hearing a lot more from her in the future, and I'm hoping this summer at Music in the Park that we will put together a band that we'll practice in June, and you'll get to hear her sing again. But I did want to mention that. I do feel bad that I wish there was more of me, or I had more time, because students like Callie get underserved for what many of her talents are. So you will be hearing more about her in the future. I also want to mention that Caroline Guffey, she has scholarshiped many places. And she has chosen to, she auditioned for the Pride of the Southland Marching Band back in February, and she found out a couple weeks ago that she made the cut and is the newest trumpet player in the Pride of the Southland Marching Band, our 5th student that we've ever sent, and the first one to receive a stipend. So let's give Caroline a hand. Are very close to each other. We've never had any kid receive money from UT before. She's the first one to get paid to be in their band. All total this year, we have 5 seniors. All 5 got scholarships. They each, combined, when you put all of them together, for 4 years, it totaled $260,000 worth of scholarships. Just remember, it may not, when they're in sixth grade or seventh grade, it may not sound promising, but I promise you, our program, the way we have developed it, it's a good program. We put kids in school. We've never had a kid that needed a scholarship not get one somewhere. So that's one of the things that I pride myself on. We work hard to put the kids in a school somewhere. I did want to make further mention that Clarksville Audio Theater, which is an independent, it's now audio theater, but it's an independent Winter Drumline that we don't sponsor or anything, but we had some kids that auditioned this year. Molly, Morgan, Caleb, and JP, who is also made a drum bugle corps, so he's not here today, but Morgan, Caleb, Molly, y'all stand up. They, every weekend since December, they were going to this thing. And they just finished last week 14th in the nation, if I remember correctly, in their category. In the world. That's true. So 14th in the world. And also, I want to mention Caroline Guffey, and she is in the Nashville Philharmonia, which is sponsored by the Nashville Symphony. She's the principal trumpet player, Caroline. And in the Curb Youth Symphony, their principal percussionist is Connor Belcher, sitting over here. And I would encourage you to attend. They have concerts coming up that are free. And I would love you or your kids to go hear about an hour's worth of really amazing music. And to see our kids sitting there, principal, you know, that's first chair. The guys that are in charge, we may be small, but we are producing kids that individually can go toe-to-toe with anyone else. Finally, want to mention that the athlete of the fall for the athletics website was Lydia Zarchansky. The athlete of the winter was, for the middle school, was Ethan Bowles. There, stand up, Ethan. Okay. That's Ethan. Give him a round of applause. All right, so they are up. Now, they are up for athlete of the year against all the other athletes. And it would be awesome if we could get these two to be athlete of the year. So go to the tcschools.org website, click on athletics, which will open up a new window. Click on athlete of the year. Please vote for these two. Because it's good for our program to be able to do that, to have that support. I was blessed to get Coach of the Fall, and that meant a lot to me. And I did want to mention, and not to brag, but out of humbleness, that my fellow teachers at the middle school voted me Teacher of the Year this year, and that should tell you how much that they respect the music program here, because they know the work that we put in, the hard work, and they see what we do, and they honor. We actually have a couple of teachers here today from the middle school.